Welcome back to Whitney Alex Works recap of The Bachelor Season 26, Episode 8, Hometown Dates. Clayton travels across the United States meeting his final four's families, and I have to give it to the editors who made it seem like every family had it out for Clayton. And at the end of the episode, Clayton narrows his relationships down to his top three. Let's dive into this recap. We jump right into hometowns with our girl Susie up first. Clayton meets Susie in her hometown of Pocosin, Virginia. Clayton and Susie are excited to see each other as Susie is hoping everything goes well with Clayton meeting her family. But before they head off to meet the family, Susie has a surprise for Clayton. She takes him to practice jiu-jitsu, and Susie says that she learned about jiu-jitsu while living in Japan and learned that instead of having insecurities about her body, she realized that her body is a weapon, which is honestly great advice. But as they are practicing, they learn a move called shrimping, which you just can't make this up. This season just can't get away from shrimp. And after a day of jiu-jitsu with Susie, they have a conversation before Clayton meets her family. Susie says that growing up, she wanted nothing more than to leave her hometown, but when her father got very sick, it changed her perspective. And she tells Clayton that she is very close to her father, and her father's opinion is very important to her. Clayton and Susie then share a kiss as they both head out to meet her family. Clayton and Susie head in to meet her family, and Clayton admits he is nervous, which just means he cares about making a great impression. They head in, and there is laughter and a welcoming atmosphere as Clayton is introduced to Susie's mother and father, as well as her best friend and her sister. And the importance of this hometown date has to do with Susie's father, as Susie says that her father is the highest standard of a man, and she shouldn't settle for anything less. And with that, Susie is emotional about her relationship with her father, sharing with him how important he is to her. Then we see Clayton talking to Susie's father, which it seems that Susie's father is pretty welcoming and says that if Susie wants this relationship, he will support their relationship. And really, Susie's family is warm and really friendly and are just campaigning for Susie as a wonderful person. And Clayton tells them that he knows what he has with Susie, and it's really up to him to ultimately choose her in the end. We also see Susie talking to her mother after she spoke to Clayton, and she tells her daughter that Clayton has not said that he is in love with you, so she warns her daughter to proceed with caution. And at the end of Clayton's first hometown date, he sits down with Susie and they discuss how things went. Both admit they are falling hard for each other, and it's really about just continuing to build their relationship. And with that, they say goodbye to each other, and Clayton is off to his next hometown date. Clayton's second hometown date is with ICU nurse Gabby. He heads to Denver, Colorado, and they both meet up in the outdoors, where Gabby says Colorado is an outdoor mecca. They get geared up to take a hike, where Gabby quizzes Clayton on what to do if they encounter a black bear. Clayton knows his bear safety and says that with a black bear, you stand up and scare it if you have to, and with a grizzly bear, you ultimately play dead. But thankfully, the only bear chasing Gabby is Clayton, as he runs after her like a bear as they enjoy the day outside together. Gabby takes Clayton to a local or made-up spot called Proposal Rock, where they kiss each other and really connect further. Then they head to an outdoor hot tub and they talk about who Clayton will meet. Gabby says that some of her extended family will be there, but unfortunately her father could not make it because Gabby tells Clayton that her father's girlfriend has cancer, and because of COVID-19, they didn't want to risk his father's girlfriend's health. Well, Gabby is an ICU nurse, so she is definitely sensitive to health and safety issues. Clayton and Gabby head in to meet Gabby's family. Clayton is introduced to Gabby's grandfather, John, who immediately tells him good luck as he is meeting everyone. And Gabby's family is also pretty welcoming, but Gabby wished that her father could have been there to meet Clayton. We first see Clayton talking to Gabby's grandfather, John, who says that his granddaughter is a, quote, lovable dingbat, which I don't know, you get thesaurus dingbat and you'll get a range of similar words, oddball, goofball, eccentric. So Gabby, or as John calls her, Gabriella, is fun and quirky and is pretty funny, but she is also emotional and is very sensitive. John warns Clayton that they should take their time together and that he better be good to her. And as Clayton is talking to Gabby's grandfather, Gabby is talking to her extended family and tells them that she hasn't told Clayton that she is falling in love with him yet. And we also see Gabby talking to her grandfather, and they have a really cute relationship with them joking around as Gabby's grandpa says Clayton is basically full of shit, and then they laugh about it, which is amazing. But throughout the whole hometown date, Gabby just wishes that her father could have been there, and then all of a sudden there is a surprise visitor. Gabby's father has arrived, but he pulls a Rick Grimes from the movie Love Actually, telling her he loves her and hopes to meet Clayton soon. And it's a sweet moment as Gabby is in full tears, but happy tears, as she heads back in and tells everyone that her father did show up, which meant the world to her. And I believe if Clayton doesn't end up with Gabby, Gabby might be a top contender to be the next Bachelorette of the franchise, considering her hometown and storyline had the most screen time this episode, but ultimately we will see. And at the end of Gabby's hometown date, Gabby and Clayton sit down and she tells him that she is falling in love with him. And they share a kiss, knowing that this hometown date went really well and they are excited about what comes next. Clayton says goodbye to Gabby and he heads off to his next hometown date. Clayton's next hometown date is with elementary school teacher Serene from Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. They meet up and Serene asks him if he is scared of heights. And Clayton doesn't know what to make of this as they seem to go on a lot of thrill seeker dates together. And they end up spending the day together climbing a tower and conquering their fears, where Clayton is mostly freaking out, but Serene holds her own, crossing a pathway high in the air with more ease than her counterpart Clayton. And at the end of the tower, they have to walk off and fall down pretty high up. And again, Clayton is pretty nervous, but he ends up doing it. And Serene does it with ease, but she admits that she holds things in internally. So even though she was freaking out, she wasn't going to let fear stop her. When they're both safely on the ground, Serene shares who will be on her hometown date. She says that her mother and brother will be there, but her father will not. Serene shares that her parents got divorced when she was 2 and reminds Clayton that she has only brought home one person before, about 10 years ago when she was just 16, so introducing him to her family is a big deal for her. Clayton and Serene head out to meet Serene's family, and everything is going well, with Clayton recapping his time with Serene so far, but Serene's older brother Roland wants to talk to Clayton. Roland tells Clayton that he is worried about Serene and only wants what is best for her. He is pretty skeptical, but again, only wants what is best for his sister Serene, and is surprised that Serene was able to open up to Clayton, considering she is known to be a truly reserved person. Roland even asks Clayton if he is in love with his sister, and Clayton admits that he is not there yet and says that he is cautious about sharing his feelings at this point in his journey. Then we see Serene talking to her mother, Sherry. Serene tells her mother that she told Clayton that she is falling in love with him, and her mother is concerned about the pace of her feelings. And with that, Serene also gets concern from her brother, with him saying that he is scared she will actually get hurt through all this. Serene takes it all in, but she is still adamant and secure with her feelings for Clayton, and she is hopeful they can work it out in the end. Clayton then says goodbye to Serene, with Serene telling him again that she is in love with him, and they kiss. And it should be noted that Clayton has not yet told any of the women that he is fully in love with them yet. Last but not least is Clayton's hometown date with our pilot, Rachel. Rachel is from Central Florida and is excited to show Clayton around. She has lost her voice, but that won't stop her from having a great time with Clayton. And just like Gabby's hometown date, Rachel brings Clayton to the outdoors and they go kayaking in the wilds, where they see a gigantic hairy spider, and Clayton is freaking out about all the wildlife in Florida as there are alligators in the area. Eventually, these two head to a nice cove that is labeled the Kissing Tree. Clayton and Rachel spend the day kissing and then kissing some more, but when they finally come up for air, Rachel warns Clayton of meeting her father. Apparently, Rachel's father is one of those dads that don't really like anyone she will bring home, and Clayton has been warned that most likely Rachel's father will give him a hard time. Of course, this stresses Rachel out, hoping that her father will hopefully play nice and approve of Clayton. So here we are. Clayton is ready to head inside and meet Rachel's family. Her mother is overly welcoming, and her father, Tony, is holding a face that could be considered cautious. And as Clayton and Rachel are telling the story of their journey together, Tony's face just says it all. He seems like he's fuming. And then we see Tony talking to Clayton. He starts to question Clayton's intentions, asking him about whether or not he will support Rachel's ambitions. Clayton says he will, citing his conversations in past episodes with supporting Rachel's ambitions to be a working woman, as well as have a family together. But Tony can't give his blessing to Clayton. Well, not until he has spoken to his daughter first. But if everything goes well, he will shake his hand and pat his shoulder as a sign of being accepted. Then we see Rachel talking to her father, and she asks him what he thinks of Clayton. And Tony says that he thinks Clayton is a nice guy, and then Rachel asks him about not approving of any of the guys she's dated in the past. And Tony admits, you know, he's a hard egg to crack. And in the end, Rachel is pretty grateful that her father approved of Clayton, as we see Tony give Clayton that handshake patting on the shoulder combo, which means Clayton has been accepted. And at the end of the hometown date, Rachel believes her feelings for Clayton are even stronger than before. They share a kiss, and Clayton says that he believes Rachel could be his wife, which is very telling. But after all of his hometown dates, Clayton is pretty conflicted, as he knows following his heart will not be easy, as he knows he will have to ultimately hurt 3 more women before choosing just one. The show then heads back to the Bachelor Mansion to have the next rose ceremony, where each woman comes in one by one, each awaiting Clayton's decision. But before all this, we see Clayton talking to Jesse Palmer, telling him that he is falling for all 4 women in different ways, and every decision from here on out is making him feel bad that he will ultimately have to hurt developing feelings. And I think that Clayton, with meeting the families, is starting to realize that his decisions have weight and emotional consequences for everyone involved. So by the time he enters the room, he knows again that he has to follow his heart. His first rose goes to Susie, and then his second rose goes to Gabby, and his final rose goes to Rachel, which means elementary school teacher Serene is heading home. Clayton walks Serene out, and Serene is pretty upset and even asked, you know, why did he make this decision? But this question is always difficult and never has a great answer. But Clayton says he has stronger feelings elsewhere. Serene is rightly hurt, and she says that she wants to close back up and hide from this pain. And with Serene heading home, we have our final 3 women, Susie, Gabby, and Rachel. And with that, hometown dates are complete, with Clayton's journey soon coming to a dramatic close, with 2 episodes airing next week, The Women Tell All on Monday, and Fantasy Suites on Tuesday. So until then, thank you for watching Whitney Alex Works recap of The Bachelor Season 26, Episode 8, Hometowns. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe to Whitney Alex Works for more videos in the future. See you soon.